Hi there. There are about 1,000 videos on the internet that give recipes for roast turkey, and this is one of them. I've spent the last few years indulging in cast iron, and in 2012, I acquired this huge cast iron Dutch oven. Since then, I've been working on a method that I hope is a good way to use cast iron to cook a huge turkey. This is the result so far. It gives a turkey that looks a little different from the classic golden brown turkey seen in most Thanksgiving photos, but since I've been making this recipe, I've yet to hear a complaint about it. It gives what folks want in a turkey. The meat is juicy and not dried out, and the skin is crisp, and the cooking time for this recipe is considerably less than what it usually takes to slow roast a turkey. So I hope you enjoy this. And I'd very much like for you to post your comments and suggestions in the comments section. This is a 16-quart cast iron Dutch oven from Bayou Classic. It's made in Asia, and the reason why I got this is because Lodge simply doesn't make a pot this big. By itself, this pot weighs 35 pounds, and when you add the weight of a large turkey to this, you're looking at over 50 pounds going onto the rack of your oven. So, if you're going to use a pot like this, be sure to consider whether your oven racks will handle the weight. For this reason, a few years ago, I went to Home Depot and constructed these custom-made racks out of black steel gas pipe. If you're lucky enough to own a vintage cast iron oval roaster, or you have a lighter roaster, such as one from Le Creuset, you probably won't have to worry about your oven collapsing before the turkey is done. Oh, one other thing. Last year, I used an excellent recipe for roast turkey using a huge cast iron skillet as a roasting pan. This video is about making a turkey in a large Dutch oven, and if you want to try making your turkey in a cast iron skillet or roasting pan, you can give this recipe a try.
Brining the turkey for 24 hours is very useful because you won't have to baste the turkey after it goes into the oven. This recipe uses a buttermilk brine because if it's good enough for fried chicken, then it's certainly good enough for turkey. One other good thing about this brine is we don't have to boil it in advance. Just mix it together, place the turkey in a big container and add the brine, and keep it cool while the brine does its work. After brining the turkey for 24 hours, the rest of the preparations for cooking are very easy. As mentioned before, you only need to use these heavy-duty stands if you think the weight of the cast iron pot might be too much for your oven racks. Cast iron is legendary for the way it retains heat, and we'll be using this to its full advantage here. The two parts of preparing the turkey are a spice rub for the turkey and a basting sauce to add before it goes into the oven. Both of these are optional, and you can use whatever preparations for the turkey that you feel are necessary.
Pepper.
Also, don't worry if the oven reaches 450 degrees before you finish the preparations. The cast iron pot can't get any higher than the oven temperature, so you can leave it in until the turkey is ready. This recipe doesn't cook the stuffing inside the turkey. We prepare basic mirepoix vegetables to cook inside the bird, as this will add flavor to the turkey, and the vegetables will also be used for preparing the gravy. At this point, we rinse off the turkey, rub the cavity with salt, pepper, and thyme, and stuff it with vegetables. Then, we bring in the drumsticks and cover the bird with our dry rub. Be careful. This is an extremely hot and very heavy cast iron pot. Take your time and keep everyone else far away when the turkey goes into the oven. Once the pot is in the oven, we turn the oven temperature down to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and roast the turkey for 6 minutes per pound. Yes, that's only 6 minutes per pound. After we've roasted the turkey at 6 minutes per pound, we uncover the pot and roast it for another 2 to 3 minutes per pound. I personally prefer a large turkey to reach an internal temperature of 180 degrees, so we're using a probe thermometer to make sure it reaches the correct temperature. And now it's time to start preparing the gravy. This gravy will use the giblets from the turkey along with the vegetables cooking inside the bird. At this point, we simply simmer the giblets to make broth, which we'll be adding to the pot after the turkey is done. And here at last is our roast turkey done in cast iron. And now we remove the vegetables from the turkey so they can be used with making the gravy. Preparing the gravy is a matter of bringing the turkey extras together in the pot so we don't miss the flavor from the drippings. We simmer the liquid for about 10 minutes to reduce it and sift in flour to thicken the gravy. And when it's ready, we strain the gravy to remove the extra stuff.
This video is really only a guideline, not a hard and fast rule. If you prefer your turkey with a plain skin, rather than the color and the taste this turkey had, go ahead and leave out the rub or the basting before putting it into the oven. You can certainly use your favorite recipe if you want, and you can even use your own gravy, although I'm quite satisfied with how the gravy turned out here. What I hope you'll find useful is the basic procedure used here for making a turkey in a Dutch oven, especially since this turkey was finished and served in only a little more than 2 hours. I hope you'll find this useful in using one of the most useful tools in your kitchen, a cast iron Dutch oven. So, happy Thanksgiving, and thank you for watching.